the FAR is able to identify various subtypes of reading disorders because, in my opinion, it does the most essential aspect that any test should do, and that it's based on a theory of reading. And that theory is a neuropsychological understanding of how the brain processes linguistic information. I wish I could say, take a look here, there's the angular gyrus, that's where we read. Okay, any questions? It's not that simple. There are multiple pathways in the brain that process reading. It's a very complicated skill. There's multiple things that can go wrong. So what the FAR is trying to do is capture the primary processing components of reading: phonological awareness and decoding skills, fluency skills, and we say that those fluency, what underscores fluency is something called orthography, or what orthography means is your ability to look at a collection of letters, or I should say a collection of words, and identify that word without analyzing each individual letter. You sort of just see it as a gestalt, as a whole. And at the end of the day, the rationale behind the FAR is that phonology and decoding subserves reading accuracy, but it is orthography that subserves reading speed and fluency. And if you look at the International Dyslexia Association's definition of dyslexia, it is a problem with accuracy and or fluency. If you read that definition within the first sentence, it screams to you, uh-oh, there's more than one kind of reading issue, isn't it? Some issues are more poor accuracy, some is more poor fluency, and some is a combination of both. So what we try to do with the FAR is capture that ideal based on a neuropsychological theory of reading. There are multiple pathways in the brain, some that subserve phonology, some that subserve orthography, and there's a bit of an overlap on these pathways as well. But that's what we're really trying to capture with this instrument, making a marriage between neuroscience and education. And how can we take aspects of neuroscience and put it in the classroom in a meaningful manner?